I was sitting here drinking coffee in my office the other day, and I had a great idea for a trick in Filmora that I want to teach you. What the hell was it? You know, I really should teach people how to do that flashback memory effect in Filmora. All right, that's what it was. Good job remembering stuff. If you want to learn this trick in Filmora 9, stick around. I'll show you how. Get out of my head!
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
What you want to do is find two pieces of footage and bring them down into your timeline. One piece of footage is going to represent your present time, what's happening now, and the other piece of footage is going to act as your flashback memory. Let's start by adding a few more tracks to our project. I'll click on the track manager, and I'm going to add 4 for now. That should probably get me through it. Now let's grab this first piece of footage where I'm just talking into the camera. Right-click on that and select Copy. Put your playhead back at the beginning of your project, select the second track, right-click in there, and hit Paste. That will give us an exact copy lined up right on top of our first. Let's find the section where you start thinking about your flashback, and let's split the upper duplicated piece of footage there. I'm gonna go ahead and delete the beginning part because I won't need that. And in the upper left, let's go to the Effects tab. In the search bar, let's type in water. This water effect has a really cool ripple effect that it adds to the project. Let's bring that down and drop it right onto the upper duplicate piece of footage. You can already see it begins to distort that piece of footage. Now we want this to transition in, so in the upper left, let's click on the Transitions tab. And in the search bar, let's type in Dissolve. Bring your dissolve down and put it right on the beginning of your transition piece of footage. Now you can stretch this out as far as you want in order for it to look good to your eye. But as you can see here, it'll slowly start to introduce that ripple effect. The next thing we want to do is grab our second piece of footage, that memory flashback, and let's drag that up into the track above these two. I'm going to also grab the dissolve transition and bring that down to the beginning of this track. And I'm going to stretch it out a bit. The only thing you want to be careful of is make sure you don't drag the transition past the ending point of these other two tracks, or this one won't be fully opaque before these ones disappear. So anywhere up to this point is fine, but don't take it past it, or you'll get some dark areas in your footage after the other two disappear. Let's take a look at that. You can see the ripple start to come in, and then it transfers over to my memory piece of footage. Now I want this memory footage to feel a little bit different, so I'm gonna left click on that down in my timeline, and in the upper left under the color tab, I'm going to change the LUT that I'm gonna use on this to a black and white. You can use whatever you want, it's just something to help differentiate what's happening now and what was happening in the past. And now you can see this effect take hold. When you wanna come back out of your memory into present time, all you need to do is right click on that, select Copy, select the track above these three, and hit Paste. Make sure these are lined up together, and let's shrink that down towards the end. And in the upper left, let's grab that water effect one more time and bring it down onto our footage. We'll also need something to transition back into. I'll just take the piece of footage that I used at the beginning for now, copy that, go to the top track and select it, and I'll paste that up there as well. That'll give me something to transition into. Make sure you add the dissolve transition to the beginning of this footage, but again, make sure the dissolve does not extend past where your other footage ends. That should be about right. Now you'll be in your back memory, you'll start to see that same wiggle pattern, and it'll transition into present day. This is a really simple trick that you can make seem even cooler by adding some audio effects to it. I used a little bit of wind chime as it changed over, and I put reverb on my voice using Reaper Digital Audio software.
If you want to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques, click the video that's on screen now or the ones that I'll pin down below. Peace.